This call is now being recorded.
What are you saying? I am asking how much have we completed? Anyone who can tell me? Hello? How much have we read?
Yes, Matt, sir. Sorry, you can scroll down, I can see. Sorry, yahan tak kar rahi hai. This one page is completed.
This one? Have you completed this?
Yes.
Till where had we read?
So last second paragraph in this page.
Last second?
Yes. In this paper.
I don't think so. Tell me, look at this paragraph and tell me.
Yes, sir. We have done this. I will click the game. Yes, yes.
So yes, narrator was hoping that we will be selected for the team. Then we will read further. Who will read?
Sorry, Muhammad Sahib.
Yes, read.
Yes, sir. Our cricket team member being and you are at our home. The first two.
What are you reading?
Arrive.
What is began to arrive at our home.
Yes, sir. Our cricket team member began to arrived at our home. The first to arrive was
Mani Ram Singh.
May was our best batsman.
Mani was our best
man and should have been our captain. Captain.
What are you reading? Captain.
Captain. Captain, but he was not becoming captain. He was not based on leadership. Ability is and batsmanship. It was
relax. Why are you reading like this? Read properly, read each word. Leadership abilities or batsmanship. Go slow, no problem, no need to rush. Continue.
It was received for the oldest and my elder other field than roll hand down be decided he owned the
Besides,
board. Besides, he owned the ball.
old. Okay, wait. You need to read every day. Please read every day. You need practice.
Okay, sir.
Zoher, will you read?
Yes, sir.
Read this paragraph again.
Our cricket team member began to arrive at home. The first to arrive was
Ramsing.
Ram Singh. Manny was our best batsman and should have been our captain. But he was not because
Captain.
captaincy was not based on leadership, ability or batsmanship. It was reserved
Reserved
for the oldest and mightiest
for
person
the
and my eldest brother filled that role hands down. He owned the ball. Then came
Hey,
Joe
Gobind Ramshaw.
Ramshaw, also known as slow poke, balls ran past him, and when he took to he swung his bat along after they were gone past him. No amount of ridicule
Ridicule.
could ridicule could
Ridicule.
ridicule could dampen his enthusiasm
Enthusiasm.
for the game.
Okay, 1 minute. So now all the cricket team members started gathering at narrator's house. Who was the first one who came? Manny Ram Singh. So Manny Ram Singh, he was very good batsman and he should be captain. He should have been, but he was not captain. Why? Because captaincy was not based on leadership abilities or batsmanship. Means captain was not selected who was the best batsman or who was the good leader. Based on that, it was not selected. But it was reserved for whom? The person who is the oldest and the mouthiest person in the team. The person who is bigger in the age and mouthiest means one who talks most rudely and loudly. These two qualities were seen for making captain of the team. And my eldest brother means narrator's eldest brother was the captain because he filled that role hands down. Means very easily he was selected captain because narrator's eldest brother, he was the oldest team player and he was mouthiest. He talked very rudely and loudly, so he was the captain. Besides, he owned the ball, means he had got the ball with his pocket money, so he was the owner of the ball. Narrator's brother, and he was also the captain. After that, who came second? Jai Gobind Ramshaw. They had given him the name Slowpoke because he was so slow that the balls ran past him. And after the balls went away to the wicket keeper, then he used to swing his bat to hit the ball. He was such a slowpoke, Jai Gobind Ramshaw. But no amount of ridicule could dampen his enthusiasm for the game. Ridicule means taunt. Dampen means to water. Pani fer dena. Even if all the people used to taunt him, but they were not able to stop him, they were not able to stop him from playing. Enthusiasm means his eagerness for the game was so much that no one could stop him from playing. So Jai Gobind Ramshaw was a slowpoke. Understood?
Understood?
Yes.
Yes, continue reading. Continue.
Most noticeably missing the Sunday was
Totaram Singh.
Totaram Singh. He was a spoiled brat who cried.
Brad.
Brat who cried and threw a tantrum if he was not selected. Totaram was neither a reliable batsman nor a fielder, and the only reason he made it to the team as often as he did was because he was one of the older boys and he provided snacks from his father's shop free without his father's knowledge, of course.
Okay. So what happened now? Who came? That Sunday one player was missing. Totaram Singh. He was not there. He was a spoiled brat. He was a spoiled boy. And he was a brat. Means he was not a good boy. Like a devil. And if he was not selected, he would throw a tantrum. Means he would get angry if he would not be selected. But Totaram was not even a good batsman, not even a good fielder. Then also he was selected. Why? Because he was older. According to his age, he was selected because of his age. And second most important thing, that he used to give snacks like chips, cold drinks. He used to bring for all the team players, all the teammates. That too free of cost, because he had his father's shop and he did not even inform his father, of course. And he used to bring snacks for all the teammates, and so he was selected for the team. Understood? Understood? Why is no one answering?
Yes, understood.
Yes, sir.
Now, anyone else who wants to read?
Sir, I want to read.
Okay, Kasim Raza, read.
Yes, sir, from where? Okay. Exactly 1 p.m. We grabbed our bats and headed west across the field to face our opponents. Our opponents had not yet arrived on the scene. But we were not surprised, for their loud to make a big show of their entrance. Just as we arrived, the captain turned up as though he was hiding in the bush somewhere close by. After the toss, he retreated to the fence.
Retreated
to the fence. Took out a whistle from the pant pocket and blew a shrill note. Presently, from a house 2 blocks away, a single file of teenage boys began to march in the field.
Okay. Now what happened? It was 1 o'clock afternoon. All the teammates of the narrator's team, they took their bats and they headed towards the field. Means they went into the ground to start the match with their opponents. But that opponents means the other team had not yet come. They had not arrived on the scene. They had not come to the ground. Why? Because every time they did this, intentionally, they came late just to make a show.
to show off that they are important, so that opponents, that rival team, always came late for playing cricket. And just as we arrived, so as the narrator's team came to the ground, the captain came out immediately because he was hiding somewhere in the bush. Behind the trees, he was hiding somewhere. So that opponent's team's captain immediately came out and they had a toss. We have seen that, right? They had a toss. And who won the toss? Narrator's team or opponents? Who won the toss?
Narrator.
No. They won the toss. After that,
opponent won the toss.
Yes. Then he retreated to the fence. Retreated means he moved back. That opponent's team's captain, he went back to the fence. And then he took out a whistle from his pocket and very loudly he blew the whistle. And as soon as he blew the whistle, what happened? A line of teenage boys, they were just nearby, two blocks away. They started marching into the field. Like how the soldiers march past, like that they came into the field. Narrator's team was waiting there. The opponent's team captain blew the whistle. And his team came like this, marching into the field, like they were showing off that they are important. What it? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Continue reading. We'll read. Who will read now? Who wants to read? Raise your hand if you want to read. Those who want to read, they will raise hand. Okay, so here, read.
Shortly the game was on. They won the toss and elected to bat. It was a smart move with the unrelenting heat. The batting side definitely had an advantage. Unfortunately, they did not take advantage of it. One by one, their wickets began to crumble and the sides was blowed out of
bowled a out.
Was bowled out of a
paltry
39 runs. Then
so what happened? Who won the toss? Opponents won the toss and they elected to bat. But you know what? Why did they elect batting? Because it was daytime. The sunlight was falling on the pitch. So definitely they will select batting so that they can make a good score. But did they make a good score? How much score did they make? How much score did they make?
39 runs.
Yes. And all the wickets started crumbling. Crumbling means the wicket fell down one by one. And they were all bowled out. Everyone, all the wickets were lost. All the 10 wickets. And they were only able to score 39 runs. They had an advantage by selecting to bat, but they were not able to take that advantage. Continue.
Sir, can I read?
Yes, Amar.
You can.
Then it was our turn to bat. Many and our captain opened the innings and together up 19 runs before our captain lost his wicket while swinging, led to a full toss. Many bet on will his parents keep betted. Will his parents
while
his parents keep a crumbling
parents?
And
read parents properly.
Parents keep.
It is not parents. Read properly, I am saying. What is this?
Patent.
No.
Partners keep a crumbling and with on run to win. I found myself the last batsman in the lineup facing the most powerful blower.
What?
First, he delivered. Oh.
What is written?
Bowler. Bowler.
Haven't you heard these cricket words? Bowler. Okay, wait. So what happened now? Now it was narrator's team to bat. How much they had to score for winning? How many runs they need for winning? Hello. How many runs they need for winning? Narrator's team. Hello. Are you all sleeping?
No, sir.
How many runs they need? How many runs they need for winning? Narrator's team. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Forty. So why all others are sleeping or what? Do you join online classes for sleeping? Then go to sleep. No problem. I won't disturb you. Then you give your exams like you give. The way you want to.
Sir, I am answering.
Yes, hardly one or two are there. So easy question I asked. The opponent scored 39 runs. How many runs narrator's team need? 40. So for 2 minutes, I did not get any answer. And then one student gives answer. And still all others are quiet. Your parents think that you are joining and you are attending classes. Please, don't disappoint them. So they needed 40 runs. And who came first for batting? Many Ram Singh and our captain. And who was the captain? Narrator's brother. So both of them opened the innings. Means वो दोनों पहले आए batting के लिए. And both of them had partnership. How many runs did they score? 19 runs. And then they lost the wicket of captain when it was a full toss delivery. You know what is a full toss, right? Directly the ball reaches the batsman without pitching. So it was a full toss and the first wicket was down. The captain was out, but 19 runs they have already scored and only one wicket is lost. And Many Ram Singh was still on the pitch. He was batting nicely, but all the partners, you know, two players will be there. One will be on strike and one will be at non-striker's end.
one for batsman, another for this side the ball.
Non-strike. So many Ram Singh was batting very nicely, but his partners kept crumbling. Means all other players did not play properly and all other players lost their wickets. Now only one run was left to win. 39 runs they have scored. Narrator's team scores level equal, but still they need one run. And you know how many wickets are down? 9 wickets. I found myself the last batsman in the lineup. So Narrator was the last batsman, and if he lost the wicket, then they will not be able to win the game, facing the most powerful bowler. So the most powerful bowler was delivering the ball, and they need last run to win, and it was the last wicket. What do you think? Who will win?
Narrator's team will win.
Okay, continue reading.
Then it was our turn. Many.
Yeah, I already explained it.
As he delivered a ball down the leg side, I pushed my bat
instinctively
out towards my leg side, and then I heard Manny call out, "Run, run!" And I begin to gallop. I was sure that I did not hit the ball, but it sounded that way because it hit a brick and glanced sideways. Nevertheless, no one objected, and we celebrated victory for all of 5 seconds. Then we begin to scatter.
Okay. Now what happened? See, the last ball the last ball, and it came down the leg side, means right side. The bowler threw the ball on leg side. I pushed myself instinctively. Instinctively means naturally. The narrator tried to hit the ball with the bat. But do you think the ball hit the bat? The ball just went past him. He was not able to hit the ball. And from the non-striker's end, Many Ram Singh, he started shouting, "Run, run, run." And I began to gallop. Gallop means to run. The narrator also started running now. But he was sure that the ball had not hit the bat. The ball had hit the brick. The ball did not hit the bat. The ball had hit the brick. So the sound had come like it hit the bat. But it actually did not hit the bat. And he glanced sideways. Means the narrator was looking.
Sir, what is the meaning of?
Of?
Brick.
Brick?
Bad.
Eat.
Okay, sir.
Eat no. You don't know brick? Red color.
Yes.
So there was a brick, and ball had hit the brick, not the bat, the last ball. But they did not have time to think. They had to take the last run. So narrator started to run. He looked on sideways, but no one objected. The opponents did not raise any objection. Means they also did not know the ball had hit the bat or not. And the narrator's team won the match, and they celebrated that victory for 5 seconds, only 5 seconds. Then we begin to scatter. Scatter means
separate out, अलग हो जाना. Now all the teammates of the narrator started to run. Why? Because the losing team will try to beat them. Let's see now. Who will read?
Sorry, can I read?
Yes, Amar.
Sorry, can I read? The losing captain assembled his men to beat us, and before they could reach the sideline to get their bats, we are using it words through the field. Their captain was a cheering or captain and instead of a talking, the shortest distance between the two points, our captain decided to run around the perimeter of the field as if he were
as
in
if
a long distance race.
Okay. So the losing team captain, what did he do? Before they could reach the sideline to get their bats. So losing team captain and his teammates, they started to collect their bat. Was a bat line again to beat the narrator's team. Before that, narrator's team started to run eastwards through the fields. They started running out of the field because the losing team would collect their bats and try to beat this narrator's team. So before that, they started running. And their captain was chasing our captain. Means the opponent's team's captain was running after narrator's team's captain. And the narrator's team's captain, he should have taken a shortcut, but he took a long cut. He ran around the field like he was in a long distance race. Instead of taking that shortcut, he ran around the perimeter of the field. Pure field mein bhag raha tha wo. And that losing team captain ran after him. In the past, when the chase of our captain appeared to be unsuccessful, the opposing team's captain would often turn his attention to one of us. So if the losing team's captain was not able to catch the captain of narrator's team, then he would try to run after any other team player. And for that reason, narrator and his team players already knew that if they won the game, they have to start running. They will not wait in the ground. They will not wait at the ground. They already knew this because this did not happen the first time. This has also happened before. Understood? So they already knew the thing that if they won the game, they have to start running and they have to run out of the ground till they reach home. And this was not the first time that they were running away after winning the game. So for this reason, as soon as they scored the winning run, they had to start running out of the ground, and everyone had to run. And today, who was the first one to run out of the ground? I means the narrator himself, because he scored the last winning run, but it was not sure. It was a dubious winning run. Dubious means doubtful, because the bat had not hit the ball. So it was dubious. It was doubtful that whether the last run was valid or not. But anyway, they won the match, and narrator was the first one to run to his house. And then others ran, and the losing team's captain and others were after narrator's team. Understood? Understood or not?
Understood, sir.
Continue. Who is reading? Who is reading?
Sir, I can read.
Sir, I.
Sarai.
Continue.
We washed up and were ready to eat.
But where are you? You don't know that you have stopped here. How can you forget?
In the past, when the chase for you, our captain, appeared to be unsuccessful. Appeared to be unsuccessful. The
openings. Read from here. From the safety.
From the safety of the bride leading
bridge.
Into our
bridge.
Bride leading bridge. In bridge leading into our home. We watched with
watch.
A relief watch, which relieved us. For captain came home in one piece, and the figures of opponents melted away into the tall grass under the orange glow of the dying sun. We had won the match and had
opponents. Wait, what are you reading? Outrun our opponents.
Our opponents.
So these last two paragraphs I explain in the next lecture. Okay, bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Hello, boys.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning,
ma'am.